some pictures of the Earth and a fictitious person telling you where they would have to tilt their neck or how they would have to tilt their neck in order to see Polaris. And I said that the angle that you tilt your neck to see Polaris is like the altitude of Polaris, and it actually gives you your latitude. So I just wanted to show you on the solar system simulator here what actually happens if you start moving around to Polaris. And so a couple things to see here. I'm looking north. There's Polaris right there, as always. We can see that the Big Dipper is relatively low right now. Here's just the handle right here, but the two pointer stars would indeed guide me up there. All the usual things are holding. I can't quite see Cassiopeia in this, but that's okay. And what I have also here in the corner is a map, and I'm sort of on the west coast here, and that arrow points exactly to where I am on the map. So let me do something now. I'd like you to maybe put a piece of tape or something on your computer screen or something, or your finger, and look exactly where Polaris is at this moment. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to move a little further south. Now, what do you expect Polaris to do? Move up or down? So before you answer, think, as I go further south, I'm going to smaller latitude numbers, because remember the equator is 0 degrees latitude. So I'm going to smaller latitude numbers. So do you expect Polaris to stay in the same position, go up, or go down? Okay, well, here we go. 3, 2, 1, go further south. Polaris went down. As I go further south, Polaris continues to go down, go down, go down, go down like that, further south. And when I get near the equator, see Polaris is behind that tree now, you'll have to think, how would I have to angle my neck to see Polaris, given that I'm way down near the equator like this? Well, if you were standing on the ground like this, it seems to me like you're looking straight ahead to see Polaris. You don't have to tilt up into the sky at all. You're looking straight ahead. And straight ahead, remember, is 0 degrees, and that's about my latitude when I'm here at the equator. Now, if I continue to go north again, start going north, start going north, I'm going to have to start tilting my neck up a little more in the sky to see Polaris, right? It used to be down here, I'd look straight ahead, but now I'm going to have to angle my neck up, 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 up to see Polaris like that. And so when I get to a place maybe about where Los Angeles is, like right around there, this angle between the horizon, I'll have to tilt up, tilt up, tilt up, tilt up. This angle is going to be about 35 degrees. And yes, you could try to do this with the hand angles that we discussed in an earlier video about looking at angular sizes of things in the solar system. Remember, your pinky and your thumb all the way apart is something like 25 degrees. Those are the same angles we're talking about. Now, if I keep going north like this, keep going north, say I'm all the way up, very close to the North Pole there, I don't see Polaris anywhere. In fact, Pollux is kind of creeping up, so where would I have to see it? Well, I'm going to have to tilt my neck up more and more and more, and then there it is right there. There's Polaris all the way up there. So remember, me dragging this mouse cursor is like you pointing your neck up. I have to go all the way up like that. And I think if I turn on something like this, you can see how high Polaris got. So I'm really high on the Earth now, almost up at the North Pole. You can see by this arrow here, and Polaris is almost up at the highest point in the sky I could possibly get, which is 90 degrees. And so again, being at the North Pole, here's the ground. I don't see Polaris anywhere. Tilt your neck, tilt your neck, tilt your neck, tilt your neck until you almost get up to 90 degrees. So again, the angle you have to tilt your neck to see Polaris is called the altitude of it, and that will be your latitude.